All right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios, and welcome back in the studio, Alan Carter, the CEO of Cabral Gold. And Alan, good to see you again.
Yeah, thanks for having me, Steve.
Talking about your project in Brazil, specifically, you've started drilling, and that's a significant point for this project. The Machiche target is where you are right now. So tell us a little bit about the drilling program, what's happening there.
Yeah, we started drilling last week, Steve, so I think we're on the third hole right now. The plan is that we'll test 9 separate high-grade targets. And so we're currently testing the first one, which is, as you said, called Machiche. Machiche is an interesting target because it lies just 500 meters north of the second largest deposit at Cuiu Cuiu. As you're well aware, we have combined resources currently at Cuiu Cuiu of about 1 million ounces. That includes inferred and indicated material. But there's an awful lot of gold there that was produced historically from the streams that's unexplained. In fact, our estimates are that 85 to 90% of the gold that was washed out of the streams is coming from other sources that are, we think, very close to the existing deposit. So this is a new target, Machiche. It hasn't been tested before. It's had no drilling, and we're quite excited.
So you're doing a lot of surface work right now, and then you found an interesting part of it that you're really intrigued by.
Yeah, we've been collecting samples on surface. As I said, it's never been tested before. We were aware that there's high-grade mineralization there from previous work that we'd done last year, and we got some results back a few days ago that suggested that the high-grade results are not that unusual for this particular target. And we've now got some very high-grade results from other parts of that particular structure, which suggests that structure could be extending in the order of over a kilometer.
Wow.
So it's pretty interesting. You know, we're picking up grab samples that are running 350 grams a ton, which is 12 ounces. And so whilst that may not be the average grade, there are a lot of very high-grade results coming out of the material that we've been collecting on surface at various points along this structure. So, in 2 or 3 weeks, we should have some drill results.
Let's talk about the east side now, because you've also... something else that's intriguing you. When Alan comes in, the first thing he says, there's two things that I'm really interested in, and this is the other thing. Tell us about the east side of this sort of area.
Yeah, the Machiche target is an east-west trending target, which is not only unusual because it's got so much high-grade mineralization on surface, it also has a very strong copper molybdenum signature to the mineralization, which makes it unique amongst the 20 to 30 targets we have at Cuiu Cuiu. The copper moly target actually, the signature, the strength of the response actually gets a lot stronger on the eastern side. So as you go further east along the structure, the copper moly numbers continue to increase, and the zone appears to get wider. And the interesting thing about it is it's not just a geochemical response that we're getting the copper and the moly on surface from all the sampling work we're doing, it's also a geophysical response. There is a very strong chargeability anomaly which suggests that the ground underneath the where we're getting the copper and the moly has some minerals associated with it which are chargeable. And we think there's a strong likelihood that that may be sulfide. So that is a target that we will move to in the next week or two. We will start testing that target. It's a large coincident copper moly gold anomaly, several hundred meters across. And again, it's had no previous drilling.
So is that going to be the order of business for a bulk of this year, is just a lot of drill testing and then seeing where, and then is it next year that you start to really sort of hone in on where you want to be?
Well, I think the honing in process has already started, Steve. As you're aware, there are a number of high-grade features on surface here that have received no previous drilling. So over the next 2 to 3 months, we intend to test 9 of these structures, 3 of which have had a little bit of drilling previously, and we've got some good results, but there are no resources associated with any of these structures
right. As
yet. The resources are elsewhere in the project. They're in close proximity, but they are not. They are separate targets. That work will be ongoing over the next few months, and there will be drill results coming through starting next month. But in parallel with that, we still have a lot of different areas of the project where we know that gold has been mined previously, historically, from the streams, and we haven't run down the source of that gold yet. So it will be an ongoing process. There will be drilling going on at the same time as a lot of surface exploration, auger, shallow auger work, and surface sampling.
But it's going to be very busy, I would think.
Yeah, it'll be a busy year. We're excited. I mean, you know, it's the copper moly signature is very unusual. This is a project I'm very familiar with. The whole belt is a very, it's an important historic gold producing region.
Right.
It's the site of the world's largest ever gold rush in history. Copper has not been extensively reported. But we do know that in the last 18 months, Anglo American Corporation has made a copper discovery, apparently a major copper discovery, several hundred kilometers to the south in similar age rocks. And incidentally, Anglo American has also staked 2.5 million hectares in the region that we're in the Tapajos, including ground on our western boundary. So it is an area that is becoming increasingly, I think, of increased interest to some of the major companies, not just for gold, but also for copper.
Well, it's going to be fascinating to learn more about it. We look forward to those drill results when they finally come out. Great to see you again, Alan. Thank you.
Thanks, Steve. Thank you.
All right, it's Alan Carter, the CEO of Cabral Gold.